Please be seated. Good morning, and thank you for joining us today to celebrate the life and the memory of Deputy Shayne York through the Highway Memorial Sign Dedication Ceremony. I'm Lieutenant Darren Harris of the Sheriff's Information Bureau. It is with great privilege and respect that I stand before you today as we honor one of our own fallen heroes, Deputy Shayne Daniel York. Deputy York was tragically taken from us in 1997 when he was shot by a suspect during a robbery after he was identified as a law enforcement officer. Deputy York, just 26 years old, a two-year veteran of the department, and the son of retired Deputy Dan York. He was described by those closest to him on the department as a great partner, a friend, and a leader at everything he did. Although he's no longer with us, he continues to touch our lives. The memorial signs are already in place on the northbound and southbound Interstate 5 freeway at the bottom of the hill. They, and the replica sign that we will unveil today, will undoubtedly help us carry on and preserve Shayne's memory and forever recollect and reflect on his sacrifice, his courage, and his service. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask that you please rise at this time for the presentation of colors and the Pledge of Allegiance. I ask that you remain standing as Sergeant Norma Maciel sings the national anthem. Uniformed personnel are to render a hand salute upon command and maintain the salute throughout the anthem.
Uniform personnel, present! Ho! I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we'd watch were so gallantly streaming.
Uniform personnel, order! Ho!
At ease, and please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, I now welcome to the lectern Chaplain Terry Harrison. We give the invocation.
Memorials are very important. After Joshua had led the people of Israel in the conquest of the Promised Land, 2.5 of the tribes wanted to cross back over the Jordan River to the eastern side because the land there was better for their flocks and for their herds. And on the way, they built a memorial. And when they were questioned as to why they built this memorial, their answer was very simple. We don't want to be forgotten. We want to be remembered as a part of the people. Memorials are important. As we think about Shayne's sacrifice in service, we never want to forget. We always want to honor him. Will you pray with me? Our Father in heaven, we give glory to your name because you are wonderful to us and give us so many things. You come to us, Father, when we're hurting. You offer us comfort and grace. And certainly at this time, as we remember, though it happened 18 years ago, the memories sometimes can be very fresh. Sometimes the pain can be renewed. And we continue to beseech you for the family, for all those who knew and loved Shayne. Father, we want to remember him and honor the sacrifice that he gave. And all those law enforcement who present their lives every day, knowing that something tragic could happen, but continue to do it day after day. We ask your blessing upon all. In your holy and righteous name we pray. Amen.
It is now my privilege to introduce those seated behind me, on my right, your left, beginning with Director Dean Gallerno, the Association of Los Angeles Deputy Sheriffs. Chief Corey Sionez, Buena Park Police Department. Representative Wyatt Woodson, Office of California Assemblymember Scott Wilk, the 38th Assembly District. The Sheriff of Los Angeles County, Jim McDonald. And Mr. Dan York, Shayne's father and our keynote speaker. And as previously introduced, Chaplain Terry Harrison. And our Executive Director, Paul Roller, of the Professional Peace Officers Association. I would like to thank and acknowledge our many special guests and members of local law enforcement, Sheriff's Department staff, and government officials who have taken time from their busy schedules to be here today. Thank you for joining us. Also with us today are a number of very special guests. They are the parents, the relatives, and close friends of Deputy Shayne York. I ask these family members and these personal friends to please stand. We welcome these very special guests with whom we share the sorrow of our tragic loss. In law enforcement, we are all a close-knit family. And Shayne will forever remain a part of us, as will you. I would now like to introduce our first guest speaker this morning, Representative Wyatt Woodson, Office of Assemblymember Scott Wilk.
Thank you for having me here today. Again, my name is Wyatt Woodson, and I'm here on behalf of State Assemblyman Scott Wilk. I'll keep my remarks really brief. It's an honor to commemorate this memorial today. You know, it's meant to be a sign of respect and public admiration for Deputy Shayne York. And we also have a certificate here today to present for him from the Assemblyman. And we would just like to say thank you to everybody in the audience, for everybody who's here today. This means a lot, and thank you.
I would like to now welcome to the lectern our keynote speaker. A man I will ever forever cherish and respect, Mr. Dan York.
Sheriff McDonald, honored guests, all law enforcement, Shayne's family, and friends. This is from the Fallen Officers Memorial page of the Buena Park Police Department. Similar to other brotherhoods that exist between professions, the same holds true in law enforcement. There is an unwavering brotherhood closely knit with a bond that cannot be broken. Close quote. We are here today to dedicate the Memorial's highway sign for my oldest son, Shayne Daniel York. What an appropriate place to hold this dedication. In the Shayne Daniel York Memorial Park, next to the Shayne York Gymnasium on Shayne York Drive. Each year on the anniversary of Shayne's passing, they hold a 24-hour vigil here at the monument. Each officer standing for a half-hour increments. As his brother Brandon would attest, Shayne would not be happy with all this attention. The only time he didn't mind the attention was at the engagement party when he was with his loving fiancée, Jennifer Parrish. The initial shock of losing a son that you consider not only your son, but your best friend, is devastating, and to lose him in such a useless and senseless killing adds even more to the burden of that ordeal. From the beginning until now, we have been overwhelmed with support and compassion from all of our friends, law enforcement, and strangers whose lives Shayne himself touched or whose lives touched by the news of his death. I have here a few recent comments written in Officer Down Memorial page for Deputy Shayne Daniel York. Retired Highway Patrol Officer Tim Liddell commented in August 2015, quote, "This week marks the 18th year since your passing from this earth. Thank you for your dedicated service to the citizens of Los Angeles County. Every time I pass by your memorial signs on the I-5, I will think of you and to your parents, peace and good fortune in the years to come." Close quote. This is from Officer Earl Cowan, Washington State Police. "Thinking of you today, brother. I met your parents today and read your story. It broke my heart. Rest in peace, and thank you for your service." Close quote. And of course, the Buena Park Police Department has had a memorial golf tournament in honor of Shayne and Bud Cates for the last 18 years. And this year, September the 12th, they will add two more names to that tournament. I am sure that Shayne's mother, Patty, is looking down on this moment, proud that her boy is being remembered in this way. Now the culmination of keeping Shayne's memorial alive, memory alive, the Deputy Shayne Daniel York Memorial Highway sign. This started out at the LA County Memorial in 2014 when I asked a simple question to Captain Britta Steinbrenner. Quote, "What can I do to get the memorial sign, highway sign for my son?" Thanks to her and the following people, this has become a reality. Lieutenant Wayne Billowett, Sergeant Brandon Epp, Legislative Unit for the Department. Assembly Member Scott Wilk, 38th Assembly District, who introduced the bill ARC 16 into the California State Assembly. ALADS for the $5,000 funding and the $2,000 unveiling. Sheriff's Relief for the funding of the unveiling. POPA, $500 funding for the unveiling. POPA Credit Union, $400 funding for the sign and $1,000 for the unveiling. Deputy Vince Romero, who assisted in coordinating with the Department of Transportation and fundraising for the signs. Sergeant McCorkle, who offered support in preparation for the unveiling event with logistics and manpower. Associate Governmental Program Analyst Sylvia Delgado, Office of the Governmental and Legislative Affairs, Department of Transportation, who communicated with Deputy Peck during the sign negotiation and design and during the production of the mock signs. Senior Transportation Engineer Lewis Lee, Department of Transportation, who designed the sign. Operation Assistants 3, Carmen Lopez, and Operations Assistant Kitty Corrales, Sheriff's Information Bureau and Special Events, who lovingly organized the unveiling event. And of course, a special thanks to Deputy Lillian Peck. Who has been by my side, keeping me informed of every little thing that has gone on with the sign since day one. Thank you to all. Our family has truly been blessed by the family of law enforcement and friends, and I have truly been blessed by a very loving and supportive family and extended family. In closing, I would like to quote Chris Cosgrove, ODMP founder, quote, "When a police officer is killed, it's not an agency that loses an officer, it's an entire nation." Close quote. All lives matter. Thank you.
It's now my pleasure to reintroduce Sheriff Jim McDonald.
Thank you. Well, it was 19 years ago, almost to the day, on Thursday, August 14th, 1997, that two thugs on a crime spree took the life of a young man, Shayne Daniel York. When two armed gang members entered a Buena Park beauty shop that evening to rob it, they threatened the safety of unarmed citizens. They took away the dreams of a young couple looking forward to a life together, and they stole the light from a parent's eyes. With the careful investigation, cooperation, and high professional standards of the Buena Park and Fullerton Police Departments, the suspects were caught and brought to justice. Shayne fought 2 days for his life and succumbed to his fatal injury on Saturday, August 16, 1997. He was only 26 years old. Family, friends, and law enforcement would never be the same. The threads of the suspect's actions reached far beyond the beauty shop, where they chose to wreak the most cold-blooded act of violence. Solely because this young man represented goodness and embodied the very antithesis of their hateful and vicious natures. They rocked the worlds of many people, caused them irreversible heartbreak, and impacted their futures. Their actions caused law enforcement personnel nationwide to change the way they conduct themselves off-duty and to reassess their personal tactics. In the aftermath of this tragedy, however, we learned what kind of man Shayne was, and that even in the face of danger, he was the premier peacemaker who asked for reason and calm, but received merciless violence instead. I didn't have the privilege of meeting Shayne, but from learning of his bravery during the incident, hearing his story, and meeting his family, I can see what a great person he was. An all-American guy who grew up in a loving family, played sports, and was liked by everyone he met. He was a stand-up young man with integrity and honor who followed in his father's footsteps to be an agent for what's good and right. He joined the Sheriff's Department in 1995 and worked right here at East Facility until his last shift in 1997. We honor Shayne today with the installation of two highway signs for everyone who travels through this freeway corridor to be able to see. Those who knew Shayne can reflect upon when they see them, and those who didn't know him can see how greatly he was appreciated. Shayne's father, retired LA Sheriff's Department Deputy Dan York, also worked here. He specifically requested the stretch of Interstate Highway 5 between Newhall Ranch Road and Hasley Canyon Road to be the portion of the roadway on the north and southbound sides dedicated to his beloved son's memory, because this was the way Shayne drove here to work. This is the route he took, the area he was familiar with, and the surroundings that he saw on a daily basis. With the introduction of Assembly Concurrent Resolution Number 16 on Thursday, January 29, 2015, Assemblymember Scott Wilkes saw the measure to designate this portion of highway through to its final approval on Wednesday, July 1st of 2015. Numerous associations and groups graciously wrote letters in support of this measure, and four local law enforcement related associations, as you heard earlier, generously funded the signs
as well as today's event. We keep our loved ones in our hearts, almost as part of our own souls. Sometimes it feels like they're right here, right by us, when we see blinks of moments with them in our mind's eye and our memories. We remember them in everything. We give thanks for the precious minutes we were together and feel blessed that they were able to share them with us. Many thanks to everyone who was involved in the process that brought us here today for their time and their contributions from beginning to end. To see the culmination of efforts 2.5 years in the making, we all appreciate you being here. Mr. York and the York family, thank you for your patience. I appreciate you and your families coming here today. We do our best to honor those we love, and I hope you see we've tried to honor Shayne and his sacrifice today. Please, Mr. York, I invite you to do the honors of unveiling the replica sign to represent the Deputy Shayne Daniel York, Los Angeles County Sheriff Memorial Highway signs. Thank you.
At this point for the unveiling of the replica sign, we'd like the family members that would like to come up, join us for the unveiling, a photo opportunity. And the Buena Park police executives and officers that are here today, please come and join us for the unveiling of the replica sign. Photo opportunity.